Once again, you see all these robots lined up as high as they can get on the HAB, moving off the HAB and out into the sandstorm of Primus. Look at all those points they earned. Over here on the blue end, you'll see 29-10, Jack and Bob, and their swerve drive. They've moved quickly, placing a hatch panel onto the cargo ship. And just like that, in goes the cargo for the Blue Alliance. 32-17, Blue Alliance. We now have a red robot playing defense down here on the blue end of the field. Keep an eye on 59-37. That's MI Robotics from Mercer Island trying to break up those scoring points by the Blue Alliance. 39 blue, 19 red. Hatch panels, high level of the blue rocket, hanging here by one piece of Velcro, but it looks like it's going to stay there in position. Another hatch panel going up onto the blue rocket. 51 blue, 25 red at 79 seconds left in this match. Two Blue Alliance robots trying to distract the red defender down on their end of the field, picking up more cargo, bouncing around, spinning. That swerve managing to evade the red robot, even though the red robot is working so diligently at their defense. Swerve manages to get that cargo and those cargo hatches where they need to go. 65 blue, 34 red, 35 seconds left in qualification match number 16. Red cargo into the end of the red cargo ship, and it goes, bringing the score a little higher for the Red Alliance. Three more points as that cargo drops, and we hear the warning for the 20 seconds. Red robots moving up on the HAB. On the blue end, we see 29-10 easily climbing and moving forward onto the high level of the HAB. 27-33, they have something going down on their end. We'll see. No, that looks like it. We'll look at the final score. And here is the final score for qualification match number 16. The win goes to the Blue Alliance. And the final score for the Blue Alliance, 93-51. What have you got for us over there for the qualification match 16?
Gary, you mentioned 29-10 and their swerve drive throughout the match. A lot of teams building swerve drives right now, but the best drive train in the world won't help you if you don't know how to drive it. And 29-10 has put in the time and energy. If you look at our match highlight here, we're going to see them put this swerve drive to good use. It's not just about how fast it is, it's about how well they control it. And on this match highlight, as we bring it up on the big screen, you'll see this is 29-10 right here. Watch what they do next as we roll this clip. They slide over, don't have to turn their robot, place that hatch panel, head back. Then they realize their alliance partner is at the feeder station, and they can just change direction on a dime, head back. Back where they need to be again. Notice they're rotating as they move. That's the advantage of the holonomic drivetrain, and they've learned how to use it as well as anybody in the world right now.
And they're so good at avoiding defending robots. They can spin off like a basketball player spinning off of a defender.
And we're ready for